When I learn how said Jesus. Hear me, O Savior divine. Open a fountain and see within. Lord, give me
eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. For as much as it has pleased the Heavenly Father and Shepherd of the Lamb to take into his eternal fold this our sister, where she will never hunger, where she will never thirst. The sun will not beat down on her, nor the scorching heat. For the Lamb at the center of the throne will be her shepherd. He will lead her unto the springs of living waters, and God will wipe away all tears. This evening, afternoon, we're gathered together for the celebration and the thanksgiving of the life of Jasmine Mae Brightson, Miss Jas. And I want to say to the family members and on behalf of the Belmont Missionary Church that we share your grief, and we know that it is a difficult time in which your loved one has passed away. And because it is a difficult time, it calls for difficult actions. At this time, you have your programs, and I'm going to be asking you if you would join with me in the singing of the hymn, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. At the same time, I want to welcome all of us who have come in from various places to share with the family at this time in their loss. And I know, as I said, it's a difficult time, but we are here and we will lift up the name of Jesus. One good thing is that our sister knew the Lord, and because she knew the Lord, we are here this afternoon not as those that have no hope, but as those who have hope. Amen. Amen. So if you can join your voices with me together, we'll do the hymn, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is Mine. Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a fortress of glory divine. Heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, washing his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior all the day long. belong. Perfect permission, perfect delight, a vision of rapture, a birth on my side. Angels descending, bring from above. Angels of mercy, whispers of love. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Final stanza, perfect submission. All is at rest. I, my Savior, am happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above. Filled with His goodness, lost in His love. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day. Can we do the chorus one more time? This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. This is my story, this is my song. Praising my Savior all the day long. Amen. We're going to be having a prayer by Deacon Carl Sr., after which we'll be having the scripture reading, and that will be done by Agapello Watson and Christopher Samuel's granddaughters, followed by a special selection, Andrea and Stefan Smith, great-granddaughters, and after that, we will have tribute from the children and another tribute by Deacon Martin Clark, who is a cousin. And then, so we take it in that order. I'm going to be asking you to ensure that you're following and that you follow in the order of that which was read. Thank you.
Almighty God, Most High God, we adore you today. We thank you, Lord, for the life of Sister Joss. We thank you, dear Lord, that she lived a full life. And Lord, as we come this evening to celebrate her homecoming, we pray, dear God, for the family. We pray, dear God, that you may just comfort them, dear Lord, this evening, as you comfort Mary and Martha when they lose their brother. Father God, we pray that you may just cover us today. We pray, dear Lord, that your Holy Spirit may just move among us. Help us to be strong in these times. Oh Lord, we can see that we are living in the ending time. So Lord, as we come, prepare us. Help us to be strong. Grant us peace. Cover us. It's a peace of God. Cover us. May your Holy Spirit cover us today, as we lay our sister to rest. Father God, we pray that you may just have your own way. In Jesus' name, amen.
This verse is taken by Ecclesiastic 3, verse 1 to 10. To everything there is a season, a time for every purpose under the heaven, a time to born, a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pluck up that which is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to break down, and a time to build up, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn and a time to dance, a time to cast away stones and a time to gather stones together, a time to embrace and a time to refrain from embracing.
A time to gain and a time to lose. A time to keep and a time to throw away. A time to tear and a time to sow. A time to keep silence and a time to speak. A time to love and a time to hate. A time of war and a time of peace. What profit has the worker from that in which he labors? I have seen the God-given task with which the sons of men are to be occupied. This is the word of the Lord. We honor it by saying thanks be to God.
For all I know, my Redeemer lives, and in the end, He will stand on the earth. For I know, my Redeemer lives, and in the end, He will reign on the earth. Though my flesh will be destroyed, yet with my eyes I will see God. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and I will stand with Him on that day. For I know that my Redeemer lives, and I will stand with Him on that day.
All my heart yearns within me for the day when Jesus returns. Oh, my heart yearns within me until the day when Jesus shall reign.
Good evening, brethren and friends. A tribute for my mom. I remember my mom to be very kind-hearted, a woman that protect her family, and also one that is hard-working for all her life. As a hard-working woman, she showed her skills as a domestic helper at Frome, Westmoreland, where she was employed for several years. She mastered this job and was very proud of what she did as it sustained her family. As the first grandchild, I was the prize of Lester Brightson and Naomi Tomlinson. After the death of Lester, mom came home to take care of her mother while assisting efficiently with the host of grandchildren and she now acquired. She also took over as the breadwinner of the household. In protecting her household, children and grandchildren, it would be the best if anyone would, with a bad mouth, kept their opinion to themselves, as she would not have you bad-mouthing any of her family members. She was also a proud and boastful mom to us. For those who traveled, we could not let her get wind of our arrival date, as she would let the entire community know before the grand arrival. Mom was very generous and free-handed, always bearing a gift, irrespective of its size. For our beloved grandchildren, for every grandparent, there are favorites. For Mom, it was Amoy, Duane, and Nikoy. Without any form of apology, Mom would call Paul and I to get her prescription filled or take her to the doctor. She would demand that we get it done almost immediately. I think she at times forget that we were adults. If it was up to her, the doctor would get all her money based on the frequency with which she wanted to visit. Or, as we say in Jamaica terms, doctor could put on him pot and wait upon her. Mama was a traveler. She would go up street to visit Amoy, then to Cave to look for Rashika, then to Sav to look for Paul. As time passed, we realized Mom was becoming shaky. But as life would have it, her situation worsened until she passed. I yearned for the opportunity to drive her around, take her on trips, give her a warm bath, or to simply sit and chat for hours. I take heart in the fact, though, that she is gone to a better place. Earth has lost a blissful or humble soul, but heaven has gained such a character. May I respect, Mom. May your soul rest in peace in the bosom of Jesus. Thank you.
Life is easy when you're up on the mountain and you have peace of mind like you never known. Then things change when you're down in the valley, but don't lose faith, for you're never alone. For the God of the mountain, He's the God in the valley. When things go wrong, He makes them right. And the God of the good times, He's still God in the bad times. The God of the day, but talk comes so easy when our life at its best. But it's down in the valley, all those trials and temptations.
Amen.
And over this year, last year into this year, I have had close call with my parents. And it flashes before my face what death really means. And so for those of the children and grandchildren, and for those of this household, I know it's difficult. When I come to the house now, I normally would see two persons sitting on the veranda, and now it's one. And I know it's going to be difficult for Aunt Lynn to be there, because normally both of them would have been sitting down there. And so I just want us to continue to encourage the family. For the children, I mean, although they are big and they are away, they were very much a part of Mama's life, Miss Joss' life. And she meant so much to them. And for all the others of us as community people, I grew up right here. And so I knew what it is to have Miss Joss as one of those persons who would discipline us, because it was not somebody who would allow you or anybody to get away with what they are doing without she saying to us, we're doing the wrong thing. And so as we sing the next song, Precious Memories, it brings back to me the fact of a woman who stand tall in this community. And so as we share in the homegoing service this afternoon, I want you to reflect on the good times we had with her. And just recognizing that she has done her part as she has walked this path on earth. We now do the hymn, Precious Memories, How They Linger. After which we will have the eulogy by Dwayne Forrester, a grandson. And then we'll have a special selection from the Belmont Missionary Church, of which she was a member.
Precious memories, unseen angels sent from somewhere to my soul. How they linger ever near me, and the sacred past and fold. Precious memories, how they linger, how they ever flood my soul. In the stillness of the midnight, precious sacred sleep unfold. Precious Father, loving Mother, fly across the lonely air. And oh, things of my childhood, in fond memory appear. Precious memory.
Hallelujah.
Precious memories, all
Precious memory, great Redeemer, the God in the valley, the God in the mountain. I just want you to know today that it's not a friction of imagination that we are just singing about something that is in the past, but it's a reality. Hallelujah. I just want to say good afternoon to everyone. Good afternoon. Hallelujah. I am happy today. I don't know about the others, but I'm happy today. The reason being, when you petition God and God answered your cry and you see it manifest, you have every reason to be happy. Hallelujah. Nestled in the heart of Belmont District, above Bluefish Bay, in the small community of Blue Hole, where on February 25th, 1937, a beautiful baby girl graced this world, born of the water, the blood, and the spirit. Jasmine Mae Brightson, birthed and parented by Naomi Tomlinson and Lester Brightson. Jasmine Mae Brightson, affectionately called Miss Jas, Auntie Jas, was also known to her sisters as Joyce. Her educational journey started at a young age, where she ventured out to acquire skills for her future. She later became a graduate of Bluefish All-Age School, where her foundation of education began. After receiving some level of personal development and education, her quest was now to become gainfully employed. However, an entrepreneur at heart was who Miss Brightson was, and so she ventured out early in the world of work to start her own business as a hidler. She made access to various markets across Westmoreland where she traded. No doubt she believed the scripture in Genesis 3, which stated, "By the sweat of your brow you shall eat bread." And so she demonstrated. Miss Joss was determined to ensure that the livelihood of her children and family was sustained. And being the industrious woman she was, she sought and gained employment at the Froom Sugar Factory, where she demonstrated her working abilities as a domestic worker at the manager's and worker's quarter. As you might already know, the ambitious and hardworking woman she was, Miss Brightson was relentless, as she was a serious breadwinner. And so she continued to look for the best job possible that would continue to supply the needs of her family. This pursuit led her to Mandeville and Kingston, where she acquired gainful employment. However, after a number of years being away from her family, Miss Joss, who was no doubt a family person, would rather be in Westmoreland with those she loved the most, her family. And so she returned to the parish. Being the industrious and ambitious woman she was, Miss Joss was able to gain employment in no time. This time at the Bluefish Police Station, where she spent most of her work life as an office attendant. Her tenure there spanned over 2 decades, and she later retired from the Bluefish Police Station in 1997. Miss Joss could be described as a loving and a caring person. And so it was very easy for her to take on the responsibility of being caregiver for grands and great-grandchildren and nephews over 20 years. Miss Brightson was not just a caregiver, but she was a goat farmer on the side. If kindness and generosity was a rule of law in the nation, Miss Jasmine Brightson would have been sentenced and spent life imprisonment at Fort Augustus. Miss Joss is the unsung hero of kindness and generosity, a definite candidate of the OMOJ Awards, the Grammy, the Golden Globe, and the Oscar Awards. Generosity were her number one song, and she was the director of kindness, a playwright of love and honesty. The food for the poor is a carbon copy of Miss Joss Brightson, awesome attribute and hallmark of giveaways. If quarrel was a criteria for the American visa at the US Embassy, and silence is denial, no doubt in Jasmine Brightson's passport would stamp denial too silent. Miss Joss favorite spot is the kitchen, and she was a soup and a dumpling lover. She ensured that when the pot lands, there was a plate for everyone. All over her kitchen's menu, written, flavor it and delight, brown stew fish and chicken bok. Thoughtfulness was Miss Joss' heartbeat. And she was the night nurse who Gregory Isaac sang about. This was who she was to everyone. She was the National Water Commission for her daughter Carole and kids' reservoir of fresh and drinkable water. She mothered grandson Nikoi from childhood to young adult. No matter how old you were, Miss Joss would always have something to give you once you visit her home. Miss Joss was never short of performing her gifting and talent that God gave her to touch lives, and in her old age, she was still a giver. Miss Jasmine Mae Brightson gave birth to her eldest daughter Carole, son Paul, and washbelly Diana. The three children continued to extend the family tree and gave her 13 grandchildren and 14 great-grandchildren. Miss Brightson's last days were not short of her golden days. She was still kind, thoughtful, and generous amidst her illness. Miss Joss was perfect in addressing her pressure, sugar, until she suffered a mild stroke. After the stroke, Miss Joss was a sign, a wonder, and a miracle to doctor. She defied the stroke by speedy recovery, and she later suffered from short of breath and was hospitalized again. However, grace and healing miracle continue to defy medicine, and she was later released. There was joy bell ringing amongst the family when the news broke of her release from hospital. Praise and thanksgiving to God was our posture of our heart, definitely, despite losing Javanna. After all the joy and praise and thanksgiving, we were told to bring her back to the hospital because of possible exposure to the virus. It was sad that those who entrusted with her care dealt with her like they have with those who are poor and vulnerable, crying out for justice daily across the nation and various news platforms. She later returned home worse than she had left after miraculous recovery with the advice that she was clear of the virus. Sunday morning, the day before she had succumbed to the stroke. We praise and gave thanks to God and serve her Holy Communion with prayer that she made it throughout the week. However, on the morning of December 14, our hearts were broken to the sad news, no doubt. However, we are reminded in the scripture that the Lord is close to the brokenhearted and save those who are crushed in spirit. Our dear Miss Jas, Jasmine Auntie Jas, and Joyce Mae Brightson went on to glory, leaving her three children, siblings, sister Lynette and Celeste, grands and great grand, cousins, nephews, and nieces. Her kindness, her thoughtfulness, and generosity will never be forgotten, but will remain in the generation now and to come. Normally, I don't say RIP, but this time, assuredly, I can say RIP. And sleep well, Mama, Miss Jas, Auntie Jas, Joyce, Jasmine, Brightson. Sleep on, beloved. Sleep and take your rest. We love you, but God loves you best. Farewell, Miss Jas.
Mary came unto the tomb of Jesus. The stone was moved, the Lord has gone away. The angel sat upon the tomb that morning. His reason did she heard him say, gone, the stone is rolled back, gone, the tomb is empty, gone, she's sitting at the Father's side. If you don't know the reason, Savior, I beg of you, don't wait too late to pray. Don't wait until the child has been completed. Don't wait until you hear him say it's too late. Sitting at the Father's side. few. Don't wait too late to pray. Don't wait until the child has been completed. Don't wait until you hear him say it's too late.
Gone, the tomb is empty. We're thankful to God that Jesus Christ is no longer in the grave. And because he's no longer in the grave, it gives us hope that one of these days, those who sleep will rise again from the dead. And this is a comfort that those who die in Christ have. As Revelation says, blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Today I want to share with us briefly from a passage of scripture, Psalm 90. A psalm that is well known. A psalm that is read on many occasions. And a psalm that I want to think that many of us have taken lightly, because we do not recognize what it is that the writer is trying to help us to appreciate. But in Psalm 90, we hear the writer saying that in verse 9 and following, for all our days has passed away in your wrath. We finish our ears like a sigh. The days of our lives are 70 years, yet their boast is only labor and sorrow. For it is soon cut off, and we fly away. For who knows the power of your anger? This afternoon I want to talk to us briefly on the frailty of man. Yes, I want to talk to us about the fact that man, as the wisest man Solomon says, is that the life of man is vanity. The life of man is in vain because it is short-lived. It is short-lived. It is short-lived, and so we need to understand that we are here, but we are not going to be here for a very long time. We are not going to be here for a very long time. So let me say to us, like the psalmist there, recognizing that we are not going to be here forever, he said that we finish our years like a sigh. You ever saw it? Something happen and you say, Just like that, the psalmist is saying, our life is like a sigh. In another place we see another writer said that the life of mankind is like a handbreadth from one corner of your hand to the other hand. Another writer said that our life is like a mist. This moment you see it, and the next moment it is gone. Another writer said that our life is fleeting. Today we are here, tomorrow we are gone. As we see in 10 and the verse 10 and the B part of it, it says that it is soon cut off and we fly away. My brothers, my sisters, and my friend, it's one thing to be here, and it's one thing to live our lives. It's one thing to be strong. It's one thing to enjoy life as it is. But there comes a time when you and I will leave from this earth. And the challenge that we face is that we have no control over when we will leave. There may be some level of measure of control as to when we come in, but as to when we go, none of us know. Because even though the doctor may give us some amount of time, we could very well outlive the timing that the doctor gives us. But the writer says that we are here for a short time. He says that the span of our lifetime is like 70 years. And there are many of us here today who may not live to see that 70 years. He moves on by saying that by reason of our strength, we may live to 80 years. And I'm certain that Miss Jess has seen that. And there are many who may not come near to that. But that is not the important thing. The important thing is what we do while we are alive. And the truth is, if we know that we are here now, but in a short time, our life will be cut off, then it means, my brothers, my sisters, and my friend, that we need to be careful how we live the life that we have. Because oftentimes we believe that because we are strong, we believe that because we have health, we believe that because we have strength, we believe that because we have possessions, we believe that because we can walk about and do the things that we want to do, then we are okay. Well, I want to tell you, my brothers, my sisters, and my friend, that life is short. It doesn't matter how long it is. The writer says it is short and it will soon be cut off and we fly away. So then hear what the writer says. He says, seeing that life is so short, whether it is 70, 80, or 100 years, the writer is saying that life is short. Then I hear him saying that seeing that the uncertainty, there's an uncertainty in life and about the time that we spend here, he moves on in verse 12 and he says, so then, Lord, teach me to number my days so that I will have a heart of wisdom. He says, Lord, teach me to take a check on how I live my life. So there are some of us today, you're strong. Yes, man. Can walk from here, go Monterey and to Robbins River and come back Brighton and come back round. And all you do is bust a sweat. There's some of us who have all the money that they could, they'll tell you that they could buy out Belmont. There's some of us who have possessions and we walk around and we boast. But I want to tell you that life is brief, and at any time, any one of us could be taken out of here. So the writer says, seeing that I could be taken out at any time, Lord, teach me to take stock of how I live my life. And so I want to say to us this afternoon that life and man is frail, and because of that, you need to take stock. You need to take stock of how you live your life. Miss Just took stock of how she lived her life. She knew that she could not continue to live the way she has been living. And so she made a commitment to follow Jesus Christ as her personal Lord and Savior. Nobody else can save you. Only Jesus Christ. He is the way, the truth, and the life. No man can come to the Father but through him. I say to you this afternoon in closing, life is brief. Today you are here. Tomorrow you are gone. God will one day bring all our work into judgment, whether it be good or whether it be evil. What will you answer God on that last day? My trust and my prayer this afternoon is that those who have not yet trusted Jesus Christ as their personal Lord and Savior, that they will take stock of their lives and that they will trust Jesus Christ before it is too late. In Jesus' name. At this time, I want to ask the family, the bereaved family, to stand where they are. And I'm going to be asking us to, in a sense, stand with them as we commit them to the Lord, that the Lord will grant them peace during this time of their grief. And so we're going to be asking you, wherever you are, to have some reverence and to just stop what you're doing as we look to the Lord in prayer. Let us pray. Our Father and our God, we want to thank you, mighty God, for this afternoon. We want to thank you, mighty God, that you are the giver of life. And we know, God, that you understand what it is to have lost your own son when he died on the cruel cross of Calvary for no sins of his own but for our sins. We know that you know what it is to experience loss. We know that you know what it means to experience grief. And so, mighty God, this afternoon we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, your only begotten son, that mighty God, you will grant unto the loved ones of our dear sister Jess, all those, her children, her grandchildren, her siblings, mighty God, and all her relatives, that you will grant unto them peace, mighty God. The peace that passes all understanding. The peace that this world cannot give. We pray, mighty God, that you will comfort their hearts. And when, mighty God, they feel distressed, we pray that you'll cause them to know that, God, you are with them. When they are in the darkest hours, mighty God, when they are in their deepest pain, like the psalmist said in Psalm 23, oh, that though you go through the valley, hallelujah, of the shadow of death, that you will fear no evil, for I am with you. God, let them feel your divine presence. Let them feel your divine comfort. Let them know, mighty God, that you have promised in your word that you will not leave them nor forsake them. So cover them now, we pray, God. And we pray that as a community that will give the support that is needed, mighty God, to those who are mourning and to those who are grieving. God, we pray that this will be a signal that as we gather here, that we will take stock of our own lives. And that as we take stock of our own lives, that God, we, those who have not yet made it right with you, that mighty God, they will give their lives to you and follow you, mighty God, in water baptism and become part of the church. Father, we thank you for what you have done. We thank you for your word that has gone forth. And we pray that your mercies will be upon us and that God will experience your peace. In the name of Jesus Christ of Nazareth, amen.
When I'm low in the spirit, I cry, Lord, lift me up, 'cause I want to go higher in thee. Jesus leads me beside still waters. Yes, he dies somewhere in the valley below. Yes, then he drew me aside to be
life at best short. We brought nothing into this world, and we can carry nothing out of it. In the midst of life, we are in the midst of death. Just as people are destined to die once. Hold that for me, please. Hold that for me, please.
One man.
Just as people are destined to die once, and after that, to face the judgment. Let us hear purpose to seek the Lord with all our heart and to respond to the opportunities of salvation extended to us through grace. At this time, we take the opportunity to commit the body of our dear sister Josh. We commit now this body to the final resting place. And for the will not be judged of the earth to do right. We do so by saying ashes to ashes and dust to dust as we await the resurrection of the dead. I'm going to be asking. We're going to be asking Elder Brightson from the Adventist Church and also a family member if he will do this prayer for us at this time. Can we be quiet?
You are the one who gives life and you are the only one who can take life away. We ask, O God, that you will help us, that you will order our steps in your way. And that each of us will make our calling and election sure, so that when you shall in your kingdom come, all of us will be privileged to go home to live with you. Guide us as we proceed this afternoon, we ask in Jesus' name.
Amen.
There's a land that is fairer than day, and by faith we can see the far. The Father went over the way to prepare us a dwelling place there. In the spirit, by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. In the spirit, by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. We shall sing on the beautiful shore. The melodious song of the blessed. When the spirits of sorrow no more, not to sigh for the blessings of rest.
Can we get some help with the singing?
Yes.
By and by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. In the sweet, by and by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. To a bountiful Father above, we will offer our tribute of praise for the glorious gift of His love and the blessing that follow our day. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on the beautiful shore. In the sweet by and by, we shall meet on the beautiful
shore. Look here, Trevor,
look here. This is my story. This is my God. This is my Savior. All the day long. This is my story, this is my song, this is my Savior, all the world. Perfect submission,
all is at rest. In my Savior, I'm happy and blessed. Watching and waiting, looking above, filled with His goodness, Lord, in His love.
This is my story.
This is my story. This is my
song.
Praise is my Savior. Praise is my Savior. All the day long. This is my story. This is my song. Praise is my Savior. All the day long. What a gift of glory by and by. What a gift of glory. I'm gonna tell redemption story. I'm gonna walk on Jesus' glory by and by. I'm gonna walk on Jesus' glory by and by, by and by. I'm gonna walk on Jesus' glory by and by. I'm gonna walk on Jesus' glory. I'm gonna tell redemption story. I'm gonna walk on Jesus' glory by and by. Some sweet day, I'm going away. I'm gonna leave this world, no more to roam. Some sweet day, when life is gone. Some sweet day, Lord, I'm going away. Some sweet day. Some sweet day, when life is over. Some sweet day, I'm going away. If I leave someday, if I leave
not far away.
Praise God from whom all blessings flow. Praise Him all creatures here below. Praise Him above ye heavenly hosts. Praise Father, Son, and Holy Ghost.
The Lord bless you and keep you, and may His grace shine upon you and give you peace. Good evening, everyone. God's richest blessings.